Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Steelers TV Live. You join us from a sold-out Fly DSA Arena ahead of the what has now become traditional Boxing Day fixture between the Sheffield Steelers and the Nottingham Panthers. Face-off is scheduled for 4 p.m. and with most of the fans in their seats already, I don't think we're going to get a delay to that. So hockey is just a little over 10 minutes away. My name is Jonathan Fernley, and alongside me is Ron Shudra. And Ron, there's a buzz in the arena. There's even a little bit of excitement up here on the commentary gantry. These are the games you love, aren't they?
Oh, these are fantastic games. Big crowd, big atmosphere. Two teams that really, really need to go out there and express themselves offensively. Both are struggling a little bit. Fans are on both coaches and all the players. So it's a great game here to come out and see what both teams are made of. You want to go out and play these games. I know we've been involved in a few of them over the past with sold out buildings, and you get in the changing room. You can see that there's a bit of a conversation going on there with Paul Thompson and everything at the minute. Corey Nielsen will be doing exactly the same. He'll be telling him to get out there, be prepared mentally for the game that's going to come ahead of him.
But it's also important that as the players get themselves fired up, that they don't go over the top.
Yeah, you know, you can't just play on raw emotion. It's so difficult to play on raw emotion because what happens is you get yourself worked up too much. The easy chances that you do get become near impossible to do. The passes bounce around. You get a little bit too carried away on a forecheck or a stick lift or something silly, and you know you miss the stick and you hit a face. You get 2 minutes for a high stick or something just because you're playing right on the edge of emotion and. Using your common sense just by keeping your feet moving instead of using your stick in that, but then not going too over the top and trying to run somebody through the boards either.
Steelers have won their last two, shutout at Brayhead on Saturday night, and before that a Challenge Cup victory against the Dundee Stars in the quarterfinal second leg. The Panthers meanwhile been on a 6-game losing streak, 5 of those in the league plus also their cup quarterfinal first leg. And across those last 6 games, they've only scored 8 goals. For both of these teams, getting the puck in the net has been the issue over the last couple of months.
It is. You know, you look at the amount of firepower and the ability that the teams have. It's almost crazy the way you look at Edinburgh going out and scoring 4 or 5 goals a game here and there. Belfast come in and score 6 or 7. Milton Keynes, Guildford, all the teams that so-called don't have all the big high-scoring guys, but we now know that they do. They seem to be putting the puck in consistently, and it's the bigger team, Sheffield Nottingham, that can't seem to find the back of the net. So I'm sure Paul Thompson and Corey Nielsen have done some scoring tactics and drills in practice just to try to get these guys out of the funk that they're in.
Steelers have mixed things up slightly from Saturday night game. Well, the day's confused here around the Christmas period. From the Saturday night game against Brayhead, they did initially start with Kirk between Waugh and Fretter, but they've gone back to Tim Wallace like they did in periods 2 and 3, and we nominally think that will be the Steelers' top unit rather than their third tonight. It's all about getting Waugh and Fretter going. They got a couple of goals on Saturday night, but the form, the regular quality, just hasn't quite been there in the last few weeks.
That's true. I mean, everybody expects your top goal scorers, no matter what team they're on, to always be scoring. You're not allowed to go through slumps, you're not allowed to go through this, but a lot of other teams too also have a set of players or a set of defensemen that are out there to go against top lines. That's why you need other scoring units. Sheffield's lucky they've got Dowd and Valdix and Nielsen, which have carried the team in a lot of the games that they've needed to come out. Westerling is starting to build up a little bit, but Fretter, Waugh, Armstrong, Wallace especially, they need to put the puck in the net. We need to get a goal or two at least out of those guys a game. That first line, we're trying to get a couple of goals a game out of them, try and get one out of the Dowd line and try and sneak somewhere else. That's 4 goals. It's not impossible, but against the quality of net mining around the leagues at the minute, 1 goal is hard enough to come by right now.
So the only player missing for the Steelers tonight is young Kieran Brown, the apprentice forward. Been out for the last couple of weeks, couldn't take part in the GB Under-20s tournament up in Dumfries. He's not yet ready for a return to the lineup just yet. On the Panthers side of things, well, they've had injuries in recent weeks to Patrick Galbraith and Evan Mosey. Both are back in training, but neither are ready to return this evening. So it'll be Michael Garnett and goal backed up by Sam Gospel. Say no Evan Mosey on the forward line. But it is a Panthers team that the success early in the year was built on that depth, rolling four lines of almost equal quality.
And that's the key nowadays in the league. You can see when teams come down into the bigger buildings, they come down with two and a half or three lines. And if you can consistently roll four lines all night long, it may take you to the 10-minute mark of the third period or the 8-minute mark of the third period. But slowly and slowly, you'll build that pressure. And that pressure keeps coming up and keep going. You're just going to explode at some point.
We are in blackout here on Steelers TV Live. Reminder that you'll be able to watch the full game again if you're watching the webcast with us tonight. You can log back into the Steelers TV Live website in the coming days, and it'll be available in your archive to download and keep forever, along with any other games you've purchased from us on Steelers TV in the past. We'll also give you the goals on Facebook tonight and the YouTube highlights in the next day or so. So if you miss any of the action, we'll try and bring you the replays of all the major incidents throughout the game. And you can catch up on Facebook and YouTube as well. You can send us a tweet as well at Steelers TV Live. We can't promise we'll get to them all, but we'll try and bring you a few of them as we go through this evening's game. It's a full set of fixtures across the Elite League tonight. All 12 teams are in action, but this is the only 4 o'clock start. It's 5:30 in Manchester, where the Storm host Dundee Stars. And then there are 4 6 o'clock face-offs. Milton Keynes host Guildford, Cardiff are at home to Coventry, Fife Flyers entertain Edinburgh, and Brayhead are at home against Belfast. We'll keep you up to date with the scores when they come through. We wouldn't expect anything during the first 2 periods of this game. So the fans continue to make their way into their seats. The team flags are now out onto the ice. Fans tonight, as they've been coming in, have been given clapperboards. The atmosphere is going to be louder and a little bit more plastic and paper-based than usual. Not sure exactly what these clapperboards are made out of. It might be a bit of cardboard, but it's certainly loud. It's giving a really good rattle around this old rink now. We call it an old rink. It's Steelers' home for getting on 27 years now, but it's had the new black seats in. It's been tarted up, new sign on the front. It is the Steelers' home. And it's the biggest crowd anywhere in the Elite League this season. And there's a good travelling support from Nottingham as well. They've got a couple of blocks, front and back of the building. Over on the left-hand side of the ring, we're commentating from up high, 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 next to the White House. In fact, we're even a little bit further back than usual, because the seats that we normally keep spare to put our little replay monitor on and my notebook been taken up by paying supporters tonight, so even those seats have gone, we've had to move a little bit further back. There's nowhere left for us to go, Ron.
The only place we can go is up, and I'm not going on top of the White House, that's for sure.
So the arrival of the two teams is not too far away. Referee for tonight will be Tom Darnell. Lots of attention, as always, on the man in the middle in Steelers-Panthers games. But for now, we'll leave you with the Steelers intro video. Sending your stare.
Your mascots tonight, Kieran Smith, Bingley Amos, Amelia Denman, Liam Peters, Marcus Ryan Kitsu, Corey Butcher, and Aidan Oakes. Where's number 33? Sponsored by Unison. We call him the Moose, Irvine Lushchukov. Where's 30? Sponsored by Unison, Brad Day. Where's number 6? Sponsored by Fire Pit, Scott Orson. Where's 10? Sponsored by Envy, Andreas Yantin. Wearing number 12, sponsored by Unison, Andreas Valdix. Wearing 13, sponsored by Team Paul, Davey Phillips. Wearing 14, sponsored by Bracknell Brewery, Liam Kerr. Sheffield, the King of Sheffield, wears 15, sponsored by KTR. It's Matthew Waugh. Wearing number 17, Mika Francilia. Your captain wears 20, sponsored by Parkour Financial Services, Jonathan Phillips. Wears 21, sponsored by Bradwell Skin Services, Tim Wallace. Wearing 25, sponsored by ITM, Mark Matheson. Wears 27, sponsored by LEW Electrical Distributors, Cole Shooter. Wears 28, sponsored by Northern Crown Care, Zach Fitzgerald. Wears 37, sponsored by KTR, Matt Lacroix. Wearing 67, sponsored by Rubber Safety Hygiene, the great Colton Peretta. Wears 75, sponsored by Old Woman Police, Robert Dow. Wears 76, sponsored by Sykes Ford Turf, Levi Nelson. Wears number 81, sponsored by Northern Crown Care, Ben O'Connor. Wears number 90, sponsored by Sabre, Big John Armstrong. Wears number 92, sponsored by KTR, Jonas Westerling. On Boxing Day, your Sheffield Window Centre, Sheffield Steelers.
So the teams are now out onto the ice. I have to say, Ron, I do love those Christmas cartoons.
I gotta love them. Yeah, I sent it home to Deborah Vogt Cole, and she sent it. Oh, where'd that come from? I said, on the big screen, they're great.
Steelers are back in their regular home shirt tonight. No Christmas attire. That was purely for the Brayhead game. It's like being raffled off tonight in the shirt off the back raffle. So there'll be 20 odd winners of that raffle prize tonight. There's also going to be a huge 50-50 crowd, 50-50 prize as well tonight. We're hoping for well over £10,000. The expected reaction for the Nottingham Panthers. So we've got a lot of mascots to go and pick up the pucks from the officials tonight. We'll have the ceremonial puck drop, then we'll have the national anthem, and then we'll have the real puck drop. Looking around, there are not many seats left to be filled. Crowd's going to be 9,300 on here tonight.
Good to see.
Absolutely, this game sold out a week in advance. It sold out last year. There were tickets available right up until sort of the day before Christmas. Not this time. Demand is increasing for this particular fixture. Hasn't always been the case. There weren't always Steelers-Panthers games on Boxing Day. Go back 11 years and the Steelers played Hull Stingrays in front of 3,000.
I think it's just one of those things with the rivalry that's always been with Nottingham, and it's something good to get over the Christmas period, because you know here and in Nottingham the games are going to be pretty much sold out. So it's a great way to get some presents out as well. And we'll see which team gives out the best presents over the next 2 days.
So referee Tom Darnell is alongside linesman Danny Beresford and James Kavanagh. And we welcome onto the ice now Kyle Tomlinson, Britain's Got Talent finalist from last year, to sing the national anthem. Nothing brings people together like Christmas, and nothing brings hockey fans to the arena like a Boxing Day game against the Panthers. It's another sellout, but both sets of fans are low on optimism right now. Nottingham have dropped six in a row, and like the Steelers, have fallen behind the leaders in the title race. Both teams have struggled for goals in recent weeks, but a big occasion and a big crowd might just spark things back into life. Fans who are sitting on the couple of rows in front of us have sat down. We can see the ice again. We may be relying a lot on our replay screen tonight to bring you this game. It is packed out. Every seat that was available to be sold has been, just like it has tomorrow night down at the NIC. And although the Steelers need the win tonight, realistically, they're going to start chasing down the Devils and the Giants. Needs to be a four-point hole.
It does. Both teams, like you said, are very, very desperate for both points to get Nottingham out of the slump. Sheffield is just starting to come out a little bit. You know, they have been started to play a little bit better lately as the back half of this month has sort of come along near Christmas. But this game here, if you're not on the edge of your seats and ready to go for this one, I don't know what you're waiting for.
Cardiff lead the way on 39 points. Nottingham are in four, 6 points back, but with two in hand. Sheffield are on 31, that's 8 points back. They've played a game more, but there's still so long remaining in the season. Some games are worth more to the fans than just a couple of points, and this is one of them. It's Steelers in orange, it's Panthers in white, it's Boxing Day, and it's sold out. This is Steelers TV Live, Jonathan Fernley and Ron Shudra. As the puck drops, the Panthers draw it back to their end. And a loud roar to greet the start of this game and possession for the Panthers captain, Steve Lee. Sauve back across to Lee. They'll try right wing side. It's broken up by the Steelers. Waugh got his stick on it. Very nearly played it with a high stick. The Steelers will get this from in front of the benches. They'll switch it across to the far side and near side. Played out front, Owen, well defended. It was Lee got a stick to it. Spinning and shooting was Francilla, but he didn't get much on it. And it falls to Pellini. Now across to Schaller. He'll skate around Francilla. Schaller all the way around the outside. Tries to sweep it back into the crease. And Mustakov's got back. And there was also a knee down there from Fitzgerald. In fact, it was Matheson who got down and prevented a wraparound attempt as well. Lee winds and fires and blasted straight into the block. And the Steelers
penalty
will charge
right
beyond
away.
It. And that's going to be a holding call against Lee, and yeah. The Steelers are going to get an early power play.
Straight away, Lee there.
Or interference, I think, has been called.
Yeah, buries one into Matthew Waugh's ankles there, and you can see as he's going by, he changes lanes and gets in the way and breaks the stride, and nowadays that's going to be called every time. But you saw the great speed there of Schala, I think it was, just before that, just catching Francilla, maybe a little unawares. His first Nottingham derby, and it kind of went around him a little bit. Matheson and Mustakov's quick to the far post, and the guy's back in a hurry to defend on that, but big opportunity here at home for Sheffield to try to get the lead early in the game.
Steelers power play hasn't scored in its last five league games. What a boost it would be if they could score early in this one. Armstrong's wrister is just off target. Now Matheson has got Lakovic all over the back of him. Betteridge will go chasing after this one. The Panthers will commit their forwards on the forecheck during penalty kill situations. It's been a feature of their play under Corey Nielsen. But if you can transition quickly, you can get in behind. And that's what Nelson was trying to do. Valdic wants to free this one from the corner. Betteridge is in there, and it will be Valdic who emerges with it. Nelson waits down low. That's where the Steelers go. Puck is deflected away off Gagnon's leg to the far side. Armstrong, Nelson. Near side is Valdic. Puck is bobbling. It's dangerous. It's just about broken up by Lakovic and cleared away, and the Panthers will swap all four.
Good job there by Lakovic and Bettridge. Nice to see that Corey Nielsen continually uses the two younger British guys, Lakovic a little bit older, but Bettridge, to get out there and put some pressure on. And it's great great opportunity for them to build some confidence up for themselves.
Look, hammered around the board. Sauvé tries to lift the stick. Against the end boards for Spang, tries to clear it straight into Steelers' bodies. The puck is at the side of the goal and it's jammed onto the outside of the post. Vreta was there, Francilla and Moir, but there wasn't a lot to shoot at, and it went onto the outside of the goal. Here's Spang, clearing attempt off the boards again, it doesn't get out. Trying to stick handle through, it's Matthew Moir, played it back into traffic, but there was no one waiting for the Steelers. Francilla had his back turned to the play. Last few seconds of power play time for the Steelers. Westerling into traffic, down low side of the goal. Fretter was trying to jab at it, it's cleared away by Sauvé, and it'll go all the way down the ice, and that should do it for this Panthers kill. We'll get back to 5-on-5 hockey. The Steelers looking to work it in from tight and around the crease. Not so many long shots on that first power play. A little different to what we've seen from the Steelers in recent weeks, but the exception of those couple of cup games, the power play hasn't been firing. That's taken an awkward bounce off the glass. He's Bussière's driving forward, and the shot goes just wide, but Mustakov's was stretching. Yeah. And there's a penalty coming against the Steelers, and now the Panthers are going to get a power play chance of their own. Mokshantsev mishandles, and that'll bring up the whistle.
Yeah, it all starts from the bad bounce off the partition coming around. Opportunity comes around to clear the puck. It goes off the partition, right back in the high slot, and a slashing penalty coming up right about there. You can see it as they're just trying to break the play up. But anything on the hands again, you see it if anybody watches NHL and stuff like that. You see it, anything on the hands now. They're trying to get away from having the goal scorers and the point guys getting whacked across the hands 4, 5, 6 times a game. So anything up there is going to be called. So now it's Nottingham's turn to see if they can put some pressure on Sheffield, and up to Sheffield's power play and penalty killers to do what exactly the same thing that Nottingham did.
Panthers power play is just a touch under 19% across league and cup this season. Linesman stumbles, but Panthers will keep possession from the face-off and look to build with this 5-on-4 advantage. Schaller working it down low. Pass comes back to the blue line. Just about kept in when the shot was sent in from Brisebois. Again, they look back towards the blue line. Skating in and shooting and hammering it against the boards. It was off target. It's a couple of shots the Panthers have had now from good positions that Mustakov hasn't been tested on. Oh, look at that effort to pinch the puck from Phillips, and still he goes on. Great stick lift and persistence. Schaller held up at centre ice, but the Panthers will come forward through Pellini, and then he's stopped by a hit from David Phillips at the blue line. And the Steelers fans will like that piece of penalty killing.
Yeah, Robbie Farmer very lucky to get away with it there with the amount of pressure that Phillips put on him. And then he takes a nice little two-handed baseball swing at the ankles of Phillips coming through. So one of those things, like I said, you got to keep the emotion out of it and just keep playing the way you normally do.
Oh, Mokshantsev pass to Phillips wasn't a good one. And the Steelers have pinched it. Backhand attempt, and there's a penalty coming as Yamtin was interfered. Well, I think he was slashed really as he came across.
Whoa.
The front of Garnett's goal.
No, Darnell, I don't know. He's calling a holding penalty. I'm not sure what kind of holding there was on this. He's free and clear here. And if there's a penalty called on this free and clear, this should be a penalty shot. He is free and clear in on the netminder there. I'm not sure where the hold is at all. A little bit of a slash and a little bit of a stick on stick, but not an awful lot there to be called for holding. Holding, sorry.
So it'll mean a period of 4-on-4 hockey. Sauvé is in the box. This game has had a penalty-filled start. 3 minors inside the first 5 minutes. Here comes Delago. 4-on-4 hockey. There's open space. Mustakov saves and gloves. And he decides to cover up with traffic on its way in. Saw the Panthers play their cup game down in Milton Keynes back on Friday night. Both sides had 8 power play opportunities. That was a game filled with penalties, but Panthers games so far this season generally haven't had that many penalties in relative to other teams. But maybe, like you say, just the emotion, some players perhaps not up to full Steelers Panthers intensity at the moment. Certainly a really loose pass from Mukhshanta to put Phillips in all sorts of trouble. No way Zach Phillips could get back to that pass. Sove was just desperate at the end. Steelers win the scramble from the face-off. 30 seconds more of 4-on-4 until the Steelers get Marquardt back. And then they'll have a minute of power play. Armstrong can't win it down low. Brown's under pressure. He's got a couple for company in that corner. And the Steelers have taken it from him. Fretta and Armstrong working well together. Shooting opportunity comes through and Garnett saves and turns it well aside. Armstrong. Still John Armstrong switches it to the forehand, then takes the shot on, and the traffic was clear in front of Garnett for the glove save.
Yeah, good job by the defenseman there, just clearing the lane out there for a netminder to see. But you go back to the penalty situation, you know, that's one thing that this league really needs to cut down on, in my eyes. There's no way we should be getting 8, 9, 10 penalties per team per game. You know, this is something that should be more in the lines of 2 and 3. You know, it's got to be cut down a lot of it, and you look at why the penalties are coming in, and if they are, you know, reaction penalties, whether the turnaround slashes and stuff like that, things like that are the things that you need to cut out.
So 5-on-4 now in the Steelers' favour. They are on the power play. The penalty on Marquardt is over, and they've got a minute of man advantage. Nelson tries to sweep it across. He gets caught up in amongst the skates of Billingsley. He plays it to the wall. The Steelers will try and win it back from there. They do. Nelson brings it out front, tried the backhand shot, and it hit Gagnon, and then it was cleared.
Good work in the corner there. Excellent work by both teams there to try to secure the puck for themselves along the boards, and Levi Nelson just picks it up on a little bit of a loose play.
Steelers enter the zone on the left wing side. It's Robert Dowd. Try the near side and Armstrong. Now Valdix, Dowd again. Takes the shot on. Oh, the rebound nearly fell for Armstrong. The Steelers keep the play in the zone. Catch a little break. 20 seconds left. Dowd, puck arrives at him very quickly. He did well to control it. Matheson. Be so elusive. Looking for the pass. Goes blue line. The shot comes through traffic. It's right in front and it's knocked in to the empty net. The Steelers have got the owner on the power play through Levi Nelson.
Yeah, simple little play that works out really well. Excellent job by Matheson and Dowd, and a fantastic little wrist shot there through by Valdix with Dowd and Levi Nelson going through there. Garnett doesn't quite get all of it. It just shows again how important it is not to have the big bomb from the point sometime. Getting it through traffic and Armstrong coming in from the other side as well in case the rebound kicks out that way. But Levi Nelson, where he wants to be, down in front of the net, looking for those rebounds. And what happens? A little rebound comes out and he's got his stick down and he's quick enough to put it in the open net.
Saw on the replay, he had to do a little readjustment. He couldn't put it in first time, had to switch hands and then flick it in, but no way could Garnett get back in time following the initial stop. And we're back to 5-on-5 and the Steelers are into the offensive zone again through Fretta. Wallace given the opportunity again on this top unit. Steelers still pressing the corner. The Panthers have won it back. So the Steelers' goal is Nelson assisted Matheson. A 5-on-4 power play goal at 6:32. And for Levi Nelson, it's goal 11 on the season.
Yeah, great effort again, like I said. But the key to that was Matheson, his patience and time there. The amount of time and amount of work he did just to delay it and try and draw players to him. And you can see him draw the top player from Nottingham down. And then Nelson just appears out of nowhere. You can see Dowd takes Gagnon high into the high slot. And obviously the other defenseman's on the far side. So great job all the way around.
Lee with the angled shot. Flex to the far corner. Stays in play. Sticks chop at it. David Phillips to the wall. Marquardt trying to dig it out. Sove pinches up. Phillips moves it on. It's back with the Steelers. Armstrong. It across the far side. Panthers forecheck can be so difficult to break past, but it allows for a slightly easier transition across the blue line if you can get it out of your own zone. It's catch 22 really for a particular tactic. Now the Panthers will gain the zone, but we've got ourselves another penalty called here. We've got a hooking call.
Looking penalty on the Nottingham player. Not sure where that one was. Was that just before the play was...
Didn't catch that live, I have to say.
Yeah, it must have been just in front of the blue line when the puck was coming up to play there between him and the Sheffield defenseman. Bussieri's getting a hooking penalty here. Obviously, we're watching something a little bit different and didn't see that. A little bit off the play. So, again, anything up in the hands, if that's what it was, hands and body to give yourself an advantage on a tug, is going to get called by Darnell today.
Well, he said he stalled out. First 8 minutes have seen four minor penalties. We've seen one power play goal from the Steelers. It's good penalty killing from Betteridge. He's out there again with Lakovic. The pair that was successful on the Panthers' first penalty kill of the game. Now will they go on the Panthers' third? They're into the zone with Freta. Here's Westerling. In towards Waugh. Save made by Garnett, and he steers it well towards the corner because Francilla was sneaking in. He's got it now, and he goes to Freta. Still Freta. He'll think about a shot. He'll take it on. Oh, it was saved, but it wasn't held. And then Waugh. And did that get over the line? Darnell looks at it, and he says no.
Whoa.
He saved it. It was at the side of the net, and Waugh went back for another whack at it, and he was trying to lift it over that outstretched pad. I have to say, live, it didn't look in.
Matthew Waugh just banging away. It gets in behind Garnett there. Goes up his back and down. Gagnon's there. They're all battling away. But again, Freter does it. Francilla does it. They come up with a delay. Just coming up through the top of the circle to get that shot. And it's tough for the top guy. If he drops down, you pop it to the defenseman. If the bottom guy jumps up, you drop it down, and the player walks out of the corner. So very tough to defend about when you come around that top of the circle and find that little bit of a lane.
Puck cleared out of the zone. Mustakovs will settle this down. Brown is in on the forecheck. Good pass off the boards by Mustakovs. Steelers gain the zone. Still a minute of power play time. It's with Robert Dowd. Nelson's the option down low. That's where he goes. Tries near side and Valdix. Matheson. Armstrong plays it back out. And its intended destination to come all the way through to Valdix. Nelson again. It's a bit static at the moment from the Steelers. Valdix once more. Nelson brings it in front and then plays it right through the crease. Matheson at the blue line. Armstrong. Nelson. Armstrong again. Matheson. Can't find a shooting lane. Valdix. Armstrong. Good save. Garnett. Puck still live. Steelers will think about a shot again. It'll come through here. It'll be off target. It's on the outside of the net, and the Steelers free it up and keep play moving. Nelson. Final couple of seconds of penalty. The Panthers get Bussieres back. And we're 5-on-5 again. But the Steelers still press in the offensive zone with Dowd. Nelson. No way back to Dowd. The Steelers are swapping defensemen behind the play, so Nelson doesn't have so many options. Arson. Moves it on. There's the shot from Dowd. It goes to the corner. And the Panthers get it back. And Bussieres, the man who took that penalty, will bring them out of the offense, sorry, out of their defensive zone. But that's not a good square pass, and the Steelers will attack again. Shot on goal is saved by Garnett as Marquardt was trying to barrel his way past Lee. Lee, another pass that's deflected. It's intended for Pellini. It'll bounce back to the Steelers. That one is partially blocked. The Panthers gain it in the offensive zone. Farmer via a deflection. Knocked down by Fitzgerald. Leaves the puck behind, then chops at it. And then, not sure whether to come forward or backwards with Breezebar, and it could be a costly decision. The Steelers break in. And the shot from the angle is well blocked by Bussieres. He got his legs back in the way. Now here's Spang. Phillips trying to put him under pressure. We saw that here in the playoffs, how that one ended. Panthers into the offensive zone. Breezebois. Arson around. Freta doesn't get it past DeLago. Arson steps across well. Panthers have it back. It's Gerald in the way. Behind the back of the net with Pellini. Back to Spang. Breezebois. Oh, and he's left it behind, and the Steelers will try and break through, but the Panthers defensemen are across in a hurry. The backhand shot, though, still requires a save from Garnett. Matthew Waugh. Colton Freta. Out onto the forehand. The shot is off target. Takes a big bounce off the glass for Wallace. It's Spang with a stick in the way. Fretta trying to get it to War. It's broken up by Pellini and cleared out of the zone as far as Delego. And David Phillips holds him up.
And another reactionary penalty again against Nottingham. Davey Phillips does a good job keeping in the way. And Nottingham player, is it Delego, I think it is, does he come across and give him a little bit of a slap? And Sheffield's going to go on a power play again here, possibly.
Mustakovs is gone. It's 6-on-5, and the Steelers could almost be in here. But the puck just got away from Dowd as he got close towards the goal. 6-on-5. Here's Westerling. There's two at top of the crease, Phillips and Phillips. Here comes the shot through traffic, saved by Garnett. That was a really good one. He had a lot of bodies in the way before that kick save.
Yeah, it's a slashing penalty coming up here. One of those things, like we said at the top of the show, is you cannot let your emotion get away with it. There was no problem with what Phillips did there, and Derlego just loses the plot a little bit, takes a slashing penalty for it. We'll see it here coming up on the near side. There's nothing wrong here. Puck goes by, pushes him a little bit. Well, watch coming up, right? Coming up. There's a bit of a spear, a little bit of a hook in the middle. Yeah, a little bit of a dodgy one there, too, in my eyes for Darnell. Back in the old days, that wouldn't even been looked at. But, you know, again, it's up in the belly area, and it's a pulling and a yanking situation. And he's obviously going to start calling stuff like that, so you need to know that that's going to be called.
Oh, it was played out nicely for Armstrong, but there was a stick in there from Betteridge. Betteridge and Lakovic have been the Panthers' best penalty-killing pair so far in this game. They were out on the first and the third, and they killed those. They weren't out on the second, and they conceded on that one. And the starting pair of forwards for the Panthers as they try and survive another 2 minutes of Sheffield pressure. Nelson. Valdix. Can't find the pass into the crease. The Steelers will work it across to the one-timer. Another good block by Betteridge. Dowd keeps that one in the zone, and Lakovic will have a crowd quickly on him. And the Steelers, oh, they won it away from the boards, but can't keep it in the zone. They'll have to just back up and reset. Valdix. Matheson. Steelers happy to be patient. Then the shot comes in. Big rebound off Garnett. And again, it's Betteridge who is first to it. But that one got a long way off the chest of the Panthers netminder. Steelers out of the zone. And they'll gain the offensive blue line. Fretta. Nice drop pass back. All the way through to goal. War is there. He spins and he puts it a fraction wide. Now it's O'Connor. He's got a good shot on him, and he takes it on, and it's blocked away. Westerling taking over as Francilla. Fed across, there was a good active stick in there from the Panthers. Fretta. Was the screen in front. Lee got a little stick on it to poke it to the end boards. Now reinforcements arrive for the Panthers, and the penalty is killed by the Panthers. They're now 1-for-4, the Steelers, on the power play. That one is the only goal we've had so far in this game. Scored by Levi Nelson at 6:32. Steelers into the offensive zone again. And Lee will not let him be stick handled around this time by Marquardt. Usually likes to drive wide Marquardt. This time he dove to the inside. And Lee was waiting for him. Marquardt has the puck taken from him. Here goes Farmer. Backhand attempt into the near side corner. Slide up the boards, kept in by Pellini. He fires it straight into a Sheffield body. And the Panthers trip into the offensive zone comes to naught. This trip into the offensive zone for the Steelers brings about a blocker save. Good hit by Wallace. Sitting down Spang. Spang is back up and he'll go skating away now. Panthers are completing a line change behind, so there's plenty of time for Arson. Skating into traffic at the blue line, there was Zach Phillips in the way. He brings Spang into the play. Now Bussière. Couple for company, and Nelson is the one who picks his pocket. And then Dowd touches it forward, but not out of the zone. Steelers get it back for another try. And Dowd will play a really good backhand pass, and the Steelers will move into the offensive zone. Drop pass, but then a shot that was really weak from O'Connor. Didn't make good contact. Here's Nelson. Here's Dowd. Steelers switch it across. O'Connor again just had the puck slide off his stick. Baldicks and Dowd working together. Here is Dowd, fanned on the pass. He was trying to get it across to Nelson, who'd taken up a position at the back door. Steelers will flip this one in, but not very far. Gloved down by Billingsley. The Panthers will play this one forward and then complete their own line change. Steelers will nudge this one forward. Jonathan Phillips. First ice time of the night for Liam Kirk. Lakovic plays it to David Clark. He gains the red line and sends it around. Clark was checked after releasing the pass. Steelers will skate this one out of their own zone. Panthers are struggling to generate zone time at the moment. The Steelers not. Garnett slides across and kicks it away, even though it was going wide. He wanted it in the corner and out of danger. The Steelers crowd appreciating the pressure that the Steelers are putting the Panthers under in the early stages of this one. Steve Lee is furthest forward for the Panthers on this particular shift. Now it's Schaller applying the pressure. The Steelers will take the aerial route out of the zone. Try and pick up the bobbling pass, which they do. Phillips from the angle, straight into the block. Now Wallace. Shot from the angle is off target. Puck on the near side boards, Fitzgerald. Pushing and shoving, it was Sove in with a good clean hit. He needs to go and get his stick back. The hit on Freda was a good one. The bobbling puck is awkward and Schaller takes it on. And the Panthers are trying to sweep up behind Pellini. And the block is made and the Steelers need to get this clear, which they do. And now they'll attack and skate straight at Brisebois. Oh, that's good defensive work from Brisebois. He held his position and didn't allow Fretter through. Now it's Spang. Brisebois off again. Shot on Mustakov. So he'll drop this one down for O'Connor. Smart little turn in a tight spot and the Steelers once again. Moving the Panthers to one and done. Marquardt given a shove by Brown. Puck is bouncing in the corner. Panther sticks get to it. Lindhagen nearly skated into trouble, but put the brakes on at the right time. Now Brown again. Lindhagen has gone herring towards the net. And Mustakov has blocked it to the near side where Yamtin will backhand down the ice. Armstrong forward only as far as Billingsley. Panthers back onto it. That was a little aimless from Brown.
How you doing? You okay over there? That's long, a long time without between whistles.
Long time without a whistle for sure. This one is kicked into the offensive zone. We are in the final minute of the first period. Here's Mokshantsev. Now Bussières again. He'll try and skate away from Francilla, who got back just in time and the body contact forced him to the end boards. Pass across is intercepted and the Steelers will try and spring into the space that's left vacant. Here's Dowd. Pass goes beyond Valdix. Now he gets it. Andreas Valdix. Wants it on the forehand, really. Francilla's shot. And it's off target and it'll bounce for Billingsley. Off the boards. Nelson comes in and finishes his check. And now it's Nelson back onto the puck. Final few seconds of the period. Valdix goes shoulder to shoulder and loses out to Gagnon. And the Panthers have it back. Final couple of seconds. And they're not going to venture down the ice, which means that the Steelers will get a standing ovation from large parts of this Fly DSA Arena crowd. They've had a lot of time in the offensive zone thanks to four power plays. They've had a lot of offensive zone time, 5-on-5 as well. And they lead through a Levi Nelson power play goal after 20 minutes.
Yeah, it's something that we said early on, didn't we? Again, in the beginning of the show, what kind of game would it be? Would it be back and forward, up and down? And I think, you know, you look at it and the power plays do help out both teams. So the confidence grows as you get more and more time in the zone. But Nottingham, they're smart too. They're not overly attacking Sheffield when they are in the zone. They're kind of playing a little bit of a control and contained defense, letting them have a little bit of the outside. And that's why you saw maybe a little bit more puck possession than you would have normally had. Some of the other teams come in and Belfast seemed to go right at them right away. Fife was going right at them right away. Nottingham laying back just a little bit. You know, it's something that the different coaches like to do. If you can, the old adage we used to say, we'll tire them out in our end and we'll go score a goal in their end. doing all that offensive work sometimes can be tiresome. And what you do is you overplay, and you wait for that little opportunity, and you bang, and you spring the other way at 2-on-1.
Particularly when you have all the offensive zone time and you don't make it count with goals on the scoreboard, it forces maybe a defenseman to take that extra step and try and join the rush when the option shouldn't be there.
Well, and you look at the defenseman that Sheffield have. O'Connor, he doesn't like to get into play, does he? Francilla, he doesn't like to get into play. Matheson, he doesn't like to get into play, do they? So you've got three guys right there that are quite happy to be down below the goal line or down below the hash marks if they see that they've got the opportunity to cycle down and help the forwards out and try and create space and lanes. They're going to go. So if there isn't anybody backing them up and they can get a hold of it, they can break down the other way.
So on your screen now, some of the best action that we saw during the first period.
And again, you see Matheson, just how well he just controls the puck. Nottingham allows him, but the biggest thing there is Levi Nelson gets lost and comes out of the corner in behind coverage. You can see him here. Okay, everything's nice and tight here. Matheson just kind of goes up, and now the defenseman steps up a little bit too high to take the slot away right there, and Levi Nelson pops out in behind them, and the puck's in the back of the net on a nice little wrist shot goal.
And that's the only goal we've seen so far in this game at 6:32. And it was the goal scored during the penalty on Jan Sove.
Nice little football move there, wasn't it?
Jonathan Fernley and Ron Shudra here with you. Steelers players are in the tunnel waiting for the call to come out onto the ice ahead of the second period. Steelers leading by a goal to nil, scored by Levi Nelson. 5-on-4 power play. And the Steelers are making their way out onto the ice now. The Panthers down at the far end of the ice doing likewise. And Ron, we were talking during the intermission, the Steelers came in for a skate this morning. They hadn't skated since the game against Brayhead on the 23rd. Has that given them an advantage during the first?
It may have. I don't know what Nottingham's timetable was or schedule was. If they've not had that opportunity to have a little morning skate, obviously they've got the drive down here, the bus ride down. It's not a long bus ride, so they could have had maybe the possibility of that. But Corey Nielsen may have elected to say to the guys just to go out and give yourself a walk or something, and maybe that was a little bit of leg rustiness. The foot speed there on a couple of the guys was a little bit slow and a little bit sloppy on a couple of the clearing passes as well. And Sheffield just seemed to be just a little bit sharper. So we'll see if it has anything to any ill effects coming up now going into the second period. Maybe Nottingham now a little bit more confident coming out of that period, only 1-0 down with three or four power plays against them. Sheffield going to have to be a little bit careful as well. Maybe Darnell now looking the other way, knowing that there is a little bit of a tit for tat coming up, but we'll see what happens. Nottingham, I'm sure, and Corey Nielsen will have addressed some stuff in the changing room before in between periods, just like Paul Thompson would have. So 15-4 shots on goal, a little bit indicative of the power plays, like you said, but I think it's going to be an interesting second period for Nottingham more so than for Sheffield.
The ice is still a little bit wet behind the goal. That Irvin Bustikovs will be defending in this period. The official just been down to keep the puck around, see how well it's sliding. Not sure it's quite well enough at the moment for the liking of the match officials. So Ron mentioned the shot count, 15-4 in the Steelers' favour. Rest of the stats. The Steelers took 2 penalty minutes, the Panthers took 8. The Steelers 1-for-4 on the power play, the Panthers 0-for-1.
Some positives on both power plays though. You look at Nottingham, they moved the puck around fairly well. You look at the penalty killing Nottingham, had the two young guys, I shouldn't call them youngsters, like Ollie's now about 23 and Lakovic is about 27, 28. But you know, these guys are not seasoned veterans. Lakovic is, Betridge isn't, so it's good that they're giving them the opportunity. And as we get underway here, you know, you look at the ability of both teams to put the puck in the net, and we're hoping for some explosiveness coming up.
Given Betridge a couple of years, he doesn't deserve his 21, Ollie Betridge. He has been around a while, and Lakovic is in his 11th season as part of the Panthers organization. Panthers send this one in deep. Farmer did well against the boards initially to get to it. Now is Francilla in trouble in the corner. Can't get it past Schaller. Now Matheson chooses to go back towards Francilla. He keeps it moving. And there's space for Wallace. Ellis forward to Fretter. Fretter trying to put a burst of speed on, the puck slides through to the netminder, and it's covered up by Garnett.
Nice little stutter step move there by Fretter there, just using a little bit of a stutter step and a little bit of a forehand backhand, sort of not quite toe drag sort of thing, but the opportunity there to bring it back and around and get a little shot away to give himself and create a shooting lane.
Fans making their way back to the seats. The queues down on the concourse were huge for everything. A queue for the ladies, queue for the gents, and a queue 20 deep for 50-50 tickets. This price tonight is going to be enormous. Here's Nelson with the snapshot that takes a deflection and clatters into the boards and then hops past the Steelers stick on the blue line. Covering work from David Phillips. Pass down is tipped on its way. This one's going to be icing. The Steelers were short of the red line. Panthers win the race. And they'll flip the ice over. It seemed like the only stoppages we had during the first period were for penalties.
That's exactly it. You had about 5 minutes there, then you go back and forth.
Don't I know it.
I didn't want to butt in on you there. You seemed like you were in a good groove. So it's good to see when the play is going up and down, a little bit of possession. It's great to keep that atmosphere going and the crowd to get into it.
Panthers from the draw shot is into O'Connor's legs. Tight behind the goal, the Panthers will get it free with Bussière. He's given a shove against the boards and dispossessed. Good work from Dowd. Then the shot through traffic, it'll sit at the side of the goal. Mustakovs has saved it incredibly, and then it's cleared away out of the air by O'Connor and Dowd. I'm not sure whose stick it was, but Mustakovs had no right to get back to that one. It was a wide open cage.
No idea how he got a hold of that one, whether it was a pad or a stick or what, but he got just enough of it to knock it up in the air, and then the defense comes to his rescue there to knock it out of the zone.
When you've been struggling for goals in recent weeks like the Panthers have, those little things just seem to keep happening to you.
That's exactly the luck that you get, isn't it, sometimes when you're struggling. There's no reason that Mustakovs should have got to that, but he did.
Physical from Marquardt against the board. The Panthers are making a change, and Yantin seeks out the far side. Armstrong, a turn under pressure. After a second go at the pass, though, the Panthers have committed two to try and steal it. It's not been successful. Arson, Marquardt towards Yantin. Panthers hold them up in neutral ice. We'll try and bring you a replay at the next appropriate stoppage if we've got a good look at that one. Marquardt. Is out of the zone only as far as Lindhagen. He flips it in high. The Panthers want a change. The Steelers don't play a good pass down the boards. Oh, and the pass spun around. Farmer. He'll try it across now to the near side. Kirk tries to put the pressure on again. The Panthers go behind the goal. Fitzgerald touches it on. And Phillips assesses his options, one of whom is Jonas Vesterling. Now Liam Kirk. Trying to go around Sove. Still Liam Kirk. To hold it in the corner against three white shirts. Managed it for a couple of seconds. Just gives the Steeler a breather away from their own end. Francilla, that was a dangerous pass and it didn't get out of the zone. Pellini couldn't take advantage. Phillips nearly sent his team offside. Kirk recovers and he goes on. Liam Kirk centering feed. It's broken up by the Panthers. The Panthers now will spring forward left wing side. They'll enter the offensive zone. Farmer, backhand shot, who's looking for the tip from Schaller. He was just a fraction late arriving. Kirk tries to send it forwards, and it's helped out of the zone by Phillips, and the Steelers will get their fourth line off.
A little bit of a bobbly puck this period for Sheffield, just like it was with Nottingham in this end.
Oh, a little bit of a stumble there as the hit was coming in. And there might be a little bit of afters, there will. There's a penalty being called, David Phillips. As the play goes down the other end, is having words with Delago. And a push and a shove. And
it's happening at both ends at the minute. You got Clark down here with Phillips and Delago. And up on the other end, you know, the battle is starting to go. The intensity's there. A little stumble in the corner here. I don't think there was much on the hit, to be fair. We'll see it here as Matheson goes down. It's not really much of anything. It's more of a strength thing. But Phillips comes in, and you can see the roughing is going to be right there. A little punch in the head. And going to put Nottingham out on a power play. So, again, the emotions come out here. A little bobbly puck, a little stutter step here and there. And the pressure's back on Sheffield now. And we'll see if Nottingham can do anything on the power play.
So for the Panthers, second power play of the game. We expect it to be 2 minutes. Indeed, that has now gone up on the arena scoreboard against David Phillips. congratulations for Jonathan Phillips and Jan Sove to listen into. Steelers' penalty kill is still the league's best, over 89% across league and cup. It's been a real strength of theirs this season. The Panthers have had a better start to the second period than they had in the first. Got themselves a man advantage to work with here. Arsenal's clearing attempt is deflected, and Walterwell brought down by Delago. Mokshantsev. So many potential weapons on this Panthers power play. Come back to Delago. Swaps over with Mokshantsev. Phillips is lurking in the face-off circle. Panthers move it closer. They look for the backdoor play. Then fed across the crease, and it was right through everybody. Bussiere's fed it across, and no one could redirect it. Delago tries to get in front of Mustakovs. Comes across the near side. There's the shot. It hits a lot of bodies. And Yamtin takes his time and takes just the right amount, clearing it away down the ice. He didn't rush it. He didn't get caught either.
Yeah, excellent job by Fitzgerald. They're getting in the shooting lane, and all the other three Sheffield players collapsing down to make sure that the puck did get out of the zone.
Hit on Phillips. It's the puck freed up, and the Steelers take the chance to clear it. Panthers have swapped their penalty-killing unit now, and they've had a minute and 10 seconds of the man advantage. And they're in to set up once more. Try the near side and shower. Farmer is the option down low. Mokshantsev is the screen. Still shallow, holds on. He can't see anything he likes at the moment. Farmer. Mokshantsev through, and it's a little bit of a touch to help it on its way. Back with Schaller. Farmer. Farmer brings it out, shoots, save is made. Oh, and then Polinia just crashed in a fraction too hard, and the rebound came out just a little bit too far behind him. Mustakovs with the shoulder save, and that one goes out of play. And with 2 seconds left, that should just about do it for this particular power play.
Yeah, you look at the shot that came in just before that, and I don't think Mustakov saw very much of the first one. He sees a bit more of this one. This is the same sort of thing that Fretter did in the first period. Come around the top of the circle. You don't really know what to do you? There's a lot of opportunity there to take the shot, because like I say, if that defenseman jumps out, he drops it back down low, and you've got a wrap play, a rim play, or a quick pass to the high slot for a quick one-timer. So you walk that seam coming through the top of the circle, and what you're doing is you're making two or three people make a decision on what they've got to do, and then you try to find the open space from there.
Fitzgerald clears down the ice just as the penalty comes to an end, and very nearly got David Phillips through on goal. Not a position he's been in often. There's an injured Panthers player down right in front of their supporters. I have to say, I didn't spot who it was initially.
It was Phillips coming out of the penalty box, comes across on the angle and makes the hit on the Nottingham player. I'm not sure how he went down, if he went a little awkward with his leg into the boards or what, but it looks like he's up and holding on to his leg. You can see Phillips come out of the boards here.
Is it Dan Spang? He's there on the play. Yeah, I think it must be.
A little unsuspecting though when he moves to make the play, and Phillips finishes off on the check.
Steelers fans initially applauded the hit. Now the severity of the situation has been realised. It's gone very quiet here. Does look to be lower body. Spang is sort of half sitting up and communicating with the medical staff. And the Steelers club doctor comes over to lend some support.
Yeah, a bit of an awkward collision for sure, the way he went into the board. So, you know, hopefully nothing too serious. He got twisted up and too much damage is done. And hopefully he's a big, strong guy. He's a big part of their defensive core, Spang. He plays a lot of minutes, and not one of those guys that you want to lose.
So he is back up. We'll see whether he goes onto the Panthers bench or whether he goes down to the locker room. Doesn't look very comfortable right now.
Yeah, not sure if he's a bit wobbly. We'll see it a little bit coming into the thing. He's turning. He may have gone in shoulder, you know, back of the shoulder in. He doesn't look like he goes in, obviously, head first or anything into the boards from that angle. It looks like it was more of a turning away from Phillips as he comes in. And it kind of goes in with the shoulders into the board. So
there'll be some fans asking, is that boarding?
Again, we've seen it so many times when players turn at the last second and players come through and make the hit. It's such a difficult call either way. You want to try to avoid the play. I think the biggest part about boarding is, are you aware of the player coming in? And if you're aware of the player coming in and you do the turn, then is it on you as well?
Spang did go onto the Panthers bench rather than down the tunnel to the dressing room. We'll keep our eyes out for him back out on the ice later in the game. Fretter to Wallace. Red line and flipped in. Sauvé and Fretter go to the end wall. It'll be Sauvé who emerges with the puck. Switched across. Good outlet pass. Lindhagen driving inside. Good drop pass. One timer comes through and it was blocked by Matheson in front of Mustakov's. Brown kicks it to the corner, retrieves it himself. Been a better period from the Panthers. Good redirect, and Matheson was first on the scene. And then he stumbles as he tries to go around DeLego. No damage done, though, for the Steelers. Yeah, the puck has bobbled, and the skating conditions don't look ideal at this part of the ice. Still looks a little wet in places as well. Yamtin can't force this one too far down the boards. DeLego has it for the visitors. To the near side, back with DeLego, intercepted by Matheson. He steps in front. Francilla off the glass, and that'll give Markard and Armstrong something to chase. Armstrong's got it. Can he find the pass across? Oh, he was looking for Yamtin. It was intercepted by Lakovic. That's not a good pass, and then it's surely a high stick there, and it's not being called. The head snapped back from the Steelers player as Mustakov saves and hold, and as Darnell missed a high stick there.
Well, I think what it is he's turning to come up the ice and doesn't quite see the stick come up, whether the head snaps back or not. That's just one of those timing things where it doesn't quite work out for. But a couple of giveaways here in both ends. There it is. You see right there. Yeah, it looked a little different from up here, but that's a pretty good view that the referee had of that, and obviously didn't seem that it seemed like it was a high stick to him.
Markov lets Darnell know what he thinks. The faceoff is in the offensive zone for the Panthers. Dow tries to pass it clear and does so successfully from the faceoff. It's possession for Gagnon. Shansev keeps the puck moving. O'Connor tries to knock it free. Steelers nearly skated themselves into trouble as that puck went through the slot. Intercepted by O'Connor. That's a better pass forward. Valdix, support either side. Nelson drops it back to Valdix. The shot takes a deflection and goes wide. Nelson will be first to it. Inside for Valdix. Dow. Valdix tried to knock it out of the air. Couldn't manage it. Backhander from a long way out. Puck is knocked down. Panthers will get to it and skate it free. Zach Phillips. Dow's all over him, and look at him win that puck back. And get Levi Nelson moving. The angle is tight. He tries to improve it by moving inside and then shoots on the backhand, and Garnett saves it.
Nice little move outside, inside there by Nelson, and Sheffield still under pressure here in Nottingham zone.
Collision with the netminder. You know what the Panthers are going to think about that one. Well, you know what Gagnon's going to think about that one.
Yeah, well, Gagnon's got to realize and turn around and look where Garnett is on the ice there. He's 10 feet out of his own net. Levi Nelson here is going for a rebound. Look where it is. There's no...
He's controlled it with his stick, hasn't he?
Exactly, yeah. He's not even seeing where the netminder is. The netminder is well out of the crease. So, to me, that's an interference penalty for the goaltender on Levi Nelson, dragging him down. And then Gagnon comes in and gives him a little, how you doing, and they're back to the races.
Nothing's been called. You didn't miss anything while we cut to that replay. The players were just stood around. I'm sure they were jawing at each other, but there was no other action worthy of reporting. The face-off will come out of the offensive zone back into neutral ice. It looks like Dan Spang is back on left defence for the Panthers, so that's good to see. He's popped back up following that hit from David Phillips. We are still 5-on-5. We're approaching the halfway point of this game, and still that power play goal from Levi Nelson, the only one we've had so far tonight. Shallow with the long outlet pass, and it's a good one. Sent towards goal. Mustakov gloves it, and he will keep hold of it. Apologies if you've been sending messages into Twitter having a little bit of trouble accessing our Twitter feed right now. So if you have been sending in messages and we've not been reading them out, sorry for that. We've not been able to receive them. We will try and get that sorted for you as this game continues. Remember the goals from this game on Facebook tonight, the highlights on YouTube tomorrow, and also the full game download for all webcast watchers available in the next day or two. Pellini kicked from the face-off. Farmer will replace him and go up against Tim Wallace. Wallace wins the draw. Pass wasn't quite where Arson wanted it. Look at Pellini hustle after it. Just don't get it out of the defensive zone. It's a crowd in front of Mustakovs and it goes over the top. Arson was trying to buy an elbowing call from Shatler, didn't get one. Shot straight into the leg of Matthew Waugh by Brisebois. Again, Shatler and Arson, a little bit of a tangle behind the goal. Puck comes out, really good play. Mustakovs got his stick down and then Waugh finished the clearance. It was played down into a really dangerous area by the Panthers and Mustakovs was alert to it and got that paddle down. And then Fitzgerald steps forward to intercept. He'll drop it off. Played across, oh, it's not a good pass from Marquardt to Fretter. It was too far in front of him. Marquardt brings it out. The angle is tight. He has a couple of goes. And they don't really threaten. I've taken a strange kick off the glass and it'll come down to Mustakovs. Decides to leave it. Played by Matheson to Francilla, and then Francilla's left the puck behind. And across to recover in time was Matheson, but the Steelers really getting themselves in a spot of bother. Then Lee takes a stumble and he's got Armstrong all over him. Pass played out, oh, it was deflected away before it got to Yantin. This time it's the Panthers hustling back to their net and getting important sticks in the way. Francilla steps forward and wins possession. Comes back to Matheson. Pairing with real offensive upside for the Steelers. And now on to Yantin. Takes the shot on, save is made. Comes back to Yantin, shoulder to shoulder with Sauvé, and Sauvé sits him down. Marquardt. Armstrong. Given a shove, but so difficult to fully knock off the puck. Puck will go out of the zone over on the far side. David Phillips forward to no one in particular. The Steelers forward line had gone for a change. There was no right winger on the ice. Here's Stevie Lee. Leaves the puck behind for Delago. Lakovic. Clark. Back to the blue line. Panthers continue to keep it on the outside. They try and move it centrally. It's broken up by David Phillips. Bounced off his skate. The Panthers work it into a dangerous area. They send it into traffic and Mustakovs has managed to cover up.
A little bit stranger in Sheffield's defensive zone. You've actually got Phillips creating some opportunities at the top here, blocking shots and getting up here where the defenseman doesn't really want to be. As you see that puck bobble around and bounce around before it just nestles into Mustakov's padding there. But good job by Nottingham, good pressure. You see how quick both teams are when there's any sort of little mistake and how quick both teams jump on the puck and put you under that much pressure.
Fitzgerald has slapped that one clear, but it will be icing. 2.75s were chasing after it, but a short shift shouldn't cause too much problem for the Steelers on that icing call. Only really Dowd skating down the ice has expended any energy on that shift. It will give the Panthers a start in the offensive zone. Had much more zone time in this second period than they did in the first. They haven't got themselves on the scoreboard yet. Is this their time? Backhanded into the slot. Nokshantsev trying to twist away. He gets the backhand shot away and Mustakovs was down with his stick. Turning it behind. A little gaggle behind the end line. Panthers bring it back out. Backdoor play, opportunity, and Bussière's denied by Mustakovs. It was well worked from the Panthers, and Bussière's was all alone.
Yeah, you saw the great pass through the scene there. Bussière's just I don't think he gets this where he wants to put it. If you watch it, Mustakovs is across in a hurry. There's a big gap through the middle there. Plenty of time here, a little bit behind, but I think he goes far side. Yeah, right in the chest. I think he's trying to pull that maybe up to the glove side here a little bit, and you can see him look skyward, so not quite the placing that he wants, but you can see as he receives the puck, it flips up on the blade a little bit as well, and just doesn't put it where he wants to, but again, Sheffield careful between the tops of the circles. Their defensive forward maybe down a little bit too low or up a little bit too high, and they're creating that seam.
Pellini for the Panthers. Mustakov saves, he doesn't hold it, it's still sitting loose, and the Steelers will nudge it to the corner, and then Kirk will have to pick a spot down the ice, and he does so. He gives Westerling something to chase. The Panthers are retrieving possession much better during this second period than they did in the first. They'll glove this one off the boards and they'll move in dangerously. Oh, and the puck was knocked away off the stick of Schaller just when it looked as though he was about to wind and fire. Steelers will clear this one down. It's going to be icing as Kirk was way behind the play on the chase.
Yeah, just starting to tread a little bit of water here, Sheffield, coming into this this last 3 or 4 minutes. A lot of pressure in their own end. And this is what we said, is Nottingham now starting to get their legs underneath them. Maybe, like I said, they didn't get the opportunity to have that little morning skate and stretch and just come get the cobwebs out that little bit from having 2 or 3 days off, a nice turkey dinner here and there, you know, some festivities for Christmas with the families and that. So I think it's what you're seeing now, the legs are starting to go for Nottingham, and Sheffield's now got to get their leg speed back up again too.
It will be Matheson who drives forward. It's past Lakovic. Shot from the angle is off target. Westling first on the scene, trying to hold off the attentions of Clark. Good pass, David Phillips. Oh, good save made. Panthers straight back at the Steelers, trying to get the shot away. He takes a couple of deflections, and Mustakov's got a little piece of pad on it. Here's Lakovic. Panthers are looking more dangerous now than they have at any point during tonight's game. This one gets away from Clark and wire up the boards, and the Panthers can't keep it in. They'll make a couple of changes, the Steelers likewise. Long shot, Mustakov saves. And O'Connor off the boards, round the glass, and then through the legs. You're going to say this one's going to be icing, but yeah. Surely the Panthers had a chance to play that against the boards.
Well, yeah, he's pinched in on the boards as a defenseman. It actually goes through his legs, so that's a bit of a bonus call there for Nottingham. But again, you know, you look at the last couple of shots that's come through on Mustakov's, and he's not exactly held on to them. He's popped the rebounds out, and that's something that keeps the play alive and keeps the pressure on in your own zone. So something he needs to just get a grip of as well is get a hold of that puck, stop it, and try and take the whistle. That way you're not letting the other team keep building in momentum and keep getting that zone time like Sheffield did in the first period. They gained the zone time through the power play and not much hard work to keep the puck. And we're still lucky to be here at 1-0, I think. Either way, it could have been another goal for Sheffield, a goal for Nottingham. So the 1-0 score right now is keeping both teams very, very on edge.
Yeah, I've had 10 minutes without a penalty. That's at least something. Here's Wallace. Can't get past Lee, puts in a hit for good measure. Oh, looking for the lead pass, and it's not controlled. Mustakov steers it to the corner. Then the hit comes in, and the penalty will be called here. It was just a little bit high, and the gloves have been dropped. And is that going to cost Wallace a penalty as well?
It's going to be a boarding call. Is the first one there on, I think it's on Lee. Or is it?
There's Bussières with a hit initially on David Phillips.
It's the Bussières that came in. We get the boarding call again. This is another one. You know, you'll have to look through this. I missed it on the
they both dropped the gloves.
Yeah, I missed it on the replay there as I was watching it live, the action going on. So, you know, it's that fine line again where when you're going into to take the hit, and whether the player is looking and ready for it and then knows and spins, you know, and as a player is that close, they can't change lanes and do anything about it. And it's supposed to be up to the player coming in. But again, you have to take responsibility here. And this is what both teams have to realize, is players are going to finish checks. You know, whether it's a step or two steps, they're still going to come through and try and finish checks, or they're going to try and put as much pressure on as possible. And if you turn at the last minute, or, you know, if you're not actually available or conscious of players coming in, then that's when things can get overheated and the emotions can spill over. And we've seen that in the past with a lot of different altercations between Sheffield and Nottingham.
Didn't spot the right gloves on the ice, but there's no extra penalties called. So 5-on-4 in the Steelers' favour. Power play number 5 for them on the night. They're 1-for-4 so far. Haven't come too close to a second goal during this second period. The extra skater might just provide them with that opportunity. Panthers have come really close in this period. Still have a zero against their name. Here's Dowd. taps to the far side, and Nelson. Valdix. Nelson. Thought about the shot, decided against it. Valdix. Dowd will take it on, save is made, and the puck goes behind the goal. Steelers bring it back out. Matheson comes in from the corner and finds the goal!
There you go again. That's two wrist shots from the blue line on two power play goals. Not sure if it takes a deflection in front, but you can see Levi Nelson just come into your screen. Matheson's heads up, and you can see right there, it actually looks like it goes off the Nottingham defenseman. Is it Sauvé who just touches it, maybe, up and over the glove of Garnett in net? So a bit of a fortunate break there for the Sheffield power play, with a lot of pressure coming back down this end through most of the second period. But again, they get the puck to the net. It's not the big bomb again from the blue line. It's the heads-up wrist shot, looking for a shot to get through. And again, you know, it's always disheartening when you're the player that tips it into your own net, but he's obviously trying to knock the play down. And, you know, I can remember doing it tons and tons of times yourself. You see a little wrist shot coming through and you think you can get at it, get a piece of it, and you end up deflecting it either up or down. And unfortunately, things like that's exactly what happens.
The margins are so fine between a puck going over the crossbar and never being spoken of again.
Exactly. You know, you're never intentionally doing it, and you think you get enough of it, or you just screen your goalie trying to block the shot, and it just that little reaction doesn't quite work out for them.
So it is confirmed as Matheson's goal. The assist goes to Robert Dowd. It's goal 6 on the season for Matheson. And here comes Yampton looking for more and testing out Garnett. Follow-up chance. Garnett was hustling to get back. Yampton was straight onto the puck again. Oh, Arson with the one-timer just over the top. The angle is tight for that one. And it's deflected up into the crowd. That's a Christmas souvenir.
And that's exactly what it does. It gives the other, the opposition, which is in this point is Sheffield, the opportunity. We see it here again. Nice little playback. Watch Matheson head up all the time. Just a good, hard wrist shot. But look who's in front of the net again. Levi Nelson down in front of the net, where he was on the first power play goal, just causing a little bit of chaos down there, and Garnett maybe doesn't quite pick it up with his eyes just slightly being screened in front.
Good face-off win for the Panthers. Slakovic winning the draw in his own zone. Intercepted by David Phillips. This one hits the very top of the glass from Matthew Waugh, but stays in play. Possession with the Panthers. What can they do about this two-goal deficit they find themselves in? Mustakovs makes the save, but once again, it's Steelers to the loose puck first. He won't get out of the zone from Waugh, but Lakovic will help him out.
That's a good save by Mustakovs on Clark there. He doesn't see it coming through as it goes past the defenseman. He has to throw that leg out.
Clark into the zone, snaps it, and Mustakovs kicks it away. That was a good stop too. That one is a long way away from needing to be saved. Here's Lakovic. DeLego. Stumble in the corner. Clark has it. Now Bussières moves it back to the blue line. Shot through traffic. DeLego waved at it but didn't touch it. Bussières again. Penalty's been called here against the Steelers.
Yeah, it's a tit for tat in front of the net, yeah.
Garnett hasn't realised yet. Now he has, and he can go to the bench. Waugh gets onto the puck. And that's where we see the stoppage. The whistle goes. The Panthers are going to get a power play now. And a chance to get themselves on the board in this game. 3:26 remaining. It looks as though it's Wallace who's off.
Yeah, it was Wallace and DeLego in front of the net, having a little bit of a cross-checking fest between them, trying to gain position in front of the net, and it didn't quite work out for him. And just that little bit last cross-check went into Wallace's back, and he just turned around and just give that little reactionary slashing penalty across the shin pads. Like I said, those are the penalties that this league's got to cut out. They've got to stop doing all these reaction penalties. Play the game and just go at it. If they want to play the sort of North American style, well, the North American style a lot of times now is 2 or 3 penalties a game, not 10.
Power play number 3 for the Panthers. They're 0-2 so far. Trying to find a way through. Mokshantsev. DeLego. Back to DeLego. Goes to Mokshantsev. Pass into the slot. The Steelers crowd around it. Bussières fights his way onto it, but the pass won't stay in the zone. Steelers try and pinch this, and they do, through Westerling. He can be such a good penalty killer. Hustles after everything, and he skates so well. He's helped his team kill vital seconds here. Panthers into the offensive zone, trying to work this 5-on-4 situation. Zach Phillips. Pass will get past Mokshanseth, and Sauveid overcommitted.
Just a little bit too anxious to get something going here. They don't quite have control and possession, and everybody's set up the way they want, and they make that play up through the middle of the ice. It's very difficult right off the bat to do that.
Pinch this time by Colton Fretter. Angles tight, and the recovery from Farmer is good. Fretter still got onto it, though. On the backhand, is there a chance to wrap this in? Garnett's made the save. Follow-up, he saved that as well.
Wow, Garnett, great job there. But the tenacity of Colton Fretter there,
he didn't just get one, he got two, he got three. There's no way he should have got three shots out of this. This is just some poor defensive work. Farmer usually pretty good with the hands here, but he gets back in time, just about gets it away. But the two defensemen here are a bit guilty. There's the one, two of them behind the net. There's two, and they're still looking, and there's three, with three Nottingham players around looking for rebounds. So excellent, excellent hard work there by Fretter to just about put this up 3-0 with 2 minutes left in the second.
Steelers delighted to be down at that end of the ice during a penalty kill situation. First it was Wesseling, and then it was Fretter. And crucially, it was Garnett. Panthers enter the zone. Final 2 minutes of the second period. Pass was just caught in the skates of Farmer, and Fretter will just nudge this down the boards. Washington knocked that one down. He got a little piece of it. Now here's Farmer. Passes it across the blue line. Steelers quick to get sticks involved in the play. Pelini. He'll move it near side. Schaller. One-timer from the slot, and it's well blocked by Waugh, but at some cost. And out of the penalty box come the Steelers. Wallace. Arson trails the play. Arson, side of the goal. Can the Steelers put it in? Yes, they can!
Yeah, that play there all starts way back in Sheffield's end with Matthew Waugh taking a slap shot off of both feet. And a great, great job there by Sheffield getting down the ice. I think actually Garner puts this in his own net. You look at it right there. Oh, it's the defenseman that comes through and touches it. Can't quite see who it is.
It's Brisebois.
Bit unfortunate. And, you know, Armstrong's going to take that all night long. But, again, it all starts in the Sheffield end with a couple of block shots. Not even have an opportunity to get the puck at the net. And Matthew Waugh, as we said so often, he's a great shot blocker and really pays the price. And we've seen early on in the year that he's been out with some foot problems through blocking shots. Takes one off both toes, and he's the one that should get a major assist for that one.
And then just in time, out of the box was Wallace. And then Arson, and then Armstrong. And then also Brisebois, but his name won't be on the score sheet. So it is 90. Oh, another opportunity here, and Marquardt is just crowded out. There's the shot, and there's the glove from Mustergoths. So 90 from 6 and 21. Armstrong, Arson, and Wallace. And for John Armstrong, it's goal 17th of the season. He leads the Steelers in goals.
And this is an important save here by Mustergoths, coming down late in the second period. Nice glove save. Two players going to the net here. And he holds on to that. You know, we're critical of him sometimes, or I am, of the rebound control, sometimes bouncing in and out of that glove. But that's a very, very important one. And people don't realize you got two guys coming in hard there. You've just had all the pressure. You've got scored on a loose, bouncy play. And you come right back and get the opportunity to get that. And the netminder there shuts the door on you.
It's a big 49 seconds, this. All the momentum and all of the scoreboard is in the Steelers' favour. Can they get to the end of the period with a three-goal cushion intact? Nelson, down, touches it on. And he'll get to this one before Lee. Lee kicks it clear as far as Zach Phillips. Final 30 seconds. Here's Zach Phillips, good hands. But that as he brings the puck through, the puck will come towards goal. Matheson knelt down and blocked it. Francilla plays it against the boards. And it's on to Valdix, there's still time. Dowd's desperate to get up in support. Trailing play, Nelson. Oh, and he just didn't get the pass across he needed towards Dowd. Nelson again. Valdix. Final couple of seconds. The shot's got to come in. It does from the angle. Garnett saves and holds. And the period comes to an end.
I think time's just run out there. You could see Darnell just trying to make the pause there. He didn't really want to let it blow down there. Just he knew the puck was in the glove there, and he just let it go. He knew the count, the shot count, and the time count there. So excellent end of the second period there for Sheffield. Some great opportunities, and they've worked out well for him.
The period that Paul Thompson wouldn't have been too happy with through the first half of it. His team was absorbing a lot of pressure, but when their chances came, they scored on their only power play of the period, and they scored at the end of a penalty kill and have extended their lead to 3-0. It's now Nelson, Matheson and Armstrong with the goals, and the Panthers, a team who have struggled for goals recently, they haven't got any so far tonight.
Yeah, I mean, but you look at the way they played that second period, you have to be semi-positive. I know you've given up a couple of goals, but again, it was two power play goals and a goal straight after a penalty. So, you know, they've had a lot more play in the second period, and you just know that Corey Nielsen will go in there and try to build on the positives and build on that first 12, 13, 14 minutes of that period, as opposed to the last couple of opportunities that Sheffield got to put it in their net.
Welcome back to Steelers TV Live. Jonathan Fernley and Ron Shuser here with you ahead of the third period. The Steelers are leading by 3-0. Nelson, Matheson and Armstrong with the credit, although a couple of Panthers D-men also making an inadvertent contribution to those second period goals. Stat count from the period, well, it was better from the Panthers in terms of shots. They outshot the Steelers 14-10. Steelers had 4 penalty minutes to the Panthers 2, but the Steelers were 1-for-1 on their power play, and the Panthers are 0-for-2. These two teams will play again tomorrow. Is this a chance for the teams to lay down a marker ahead of tomorrow? Or have we just got 20 more minutes to see the game out? What are the Panthers going to play this like?
Well, if you're any sort of professional, you're coming in here to get 2 points. That's the main thing, is you've got to go out and do it. You don't want to go back home being 4, 5, or 6, and Sheffield will push. But again, Nottingham didn't have a bad second period. To be fair, the first period was a lot of power plays against as well. So they got out of that period. They were a bit unfortunate not to get on the scoreboard. You know, Mustakov's making an absolutely acrobatic save on one that may have turned the whole complexion of the game. And then, as you say, a couple of little deflections that are unfortunate, and Sheffield's up by 3. So I can't see Nottingham not coming out here and putting a good push out.
Even strength, 5-on-5 as we get this third period underway. Possession with the Panthers to start off. They were better in the second period. Couldn't find a breakthrough. Is bobbling around. It'll sit nicely for the Panthers. Backdoor play. Oh, they've missed the net. What an opportunity. Straight at the start of this game. Sorry, the start of this period. And Pellini, it wasn't a great angle, but not on target. And the Steelers move through. Good poke check from Lee. Sends Wallace to the corner. Now Wah. Gonna hold off a couple. Can't manage it. The puck will go to the far side. And it's Lee who will try and clear it. Fire a stick of Fretta does so, although it's been kept in the zone. And then it takes an awkward kick. Comes back to the Steelers. Oh, lovely reverse pass from Fretta. But Wah had it caught under the skates and couldn't do anything with it.
Sheffield lucky right in the opening there to get away with one, and how that would have turned the tide of the game if Nottingham had scored there in that first 30-odd seconds.
Sent in all the way around by Brisebois. Steelers settle it down, need to pass their way out, but they play it into the skates of Lakovic, and Delago helps out. Lakovic backhands it. David Phillips is there first, but it'll come to the near side and spang. Looks to be no lasting damage following that awkward-looking tumble near the boards. Following David Phillips' hit. Panthers sneak in. Mustakov saves. Puck is live at the side of the goal. Still behind the goal and still with the Panthers. Spang brings it back out. His shot takes a couple of deflections before it gets to Mustakov's. And O'Connor fires off the wall and into centre ice. Passed a couple, but find its way back to a white shirt. Lucier sends it in. Mustakovs will settle it down. Voracek is closing, and Mustakovs with a good pass around the boards to Valdix. That gets the Steelers out. And they'll switch it near side where the room is for Robert Dowd. Dowd has got Nelson with him. He tries to take over. The puck gets too far beyond him. And that allows Phillips to feed Mock Sanchez, but he has the puck knocked off his stick. Fitzgerald fed it forward. Gagnon intercepted it. Steelers will make a couple of changes with the puck down behind the Panthers' goal. It's Gerald putting pressure on Mokshantsev. Possession still with the Panthers. And that pass splits everybody. They'll have to chase all the way back into their own zone. Garnett play the pass out. Billingsley forward. Lindhagen straight into Steelers traffic. It's Jansen in the way. Matheson turns away from trouble. Nothing too adventurous from the Steelers so far in this third period. Markart. Westerling takes over. Handled at centre ice, possession back with Sove. Touch forward, played into the zone by Brown. Again, Mustakov leaves his crease. Passing attempt doesn't get beyond Brown. Panthers get a shot away, and Mustakov makes the stop to deny Betteridge. Lee flipped across and inadvertently kicked out of the zone. Sove's got to be careful. Again, a long time without a whistle here. Seconds ticking away is good from a Sheffield Steelers perspective. O'Connor switches it near side. Matheson trying to feed it forward. Westerling gains the red line, sends it in deep. He's got a couple of changes in behind the plate. They'll keep this one in the zone. Near side, shot through traffic, couple of deflections. Oh, Garnett saved once, twice, and three times. That puck bobbled, and he still kept his leg. Kicked out, and then he saved a couple of follow-up shots. That was superb. hasn't had the best look in front of goal today. Garnett with a couple of deflections off his own teammates. But he's made a couple of wonderful stops there and then kicked away that long-range wrister as well. Spang feeds this one forward and it finds David Phillips. That was Sheffield's first real scoring opportunities of this third period. Attempted hit by Brisebois on Fretter, spun around. He's just trying to take the puck away, can't manage it. Go back for seconds, it's Lakovic who will skate free. Off the boards and a chase. Arson will get back to it, and that will be icing at just the wrong side of the red line.
Some great, great individual efforts there as you see some good hard work by both teams. There's an opportunity there, and that's one that Berlini would have buried, you know, pretty much 100% of the time the beginning part of the season. And there you see the double deflection out in front. It was Kirk deflects it down first, and then it goes off Phillips and then off the post. And Garnett has to keep that leg strength down. You know, tough for goalies to do that. I mean, you'd be absolutely surprised at how strong these guys' legs are to be able to withstand pucks and stuff being nailed and
shot from the face-off. Great redirect from Dowd, but it got blocked by Brisebois. Here's DeLego. Now it's Lakovic. Just stumbles slightly, but does well to recover. Tension from Nelson. And then Nelson gets his stick to the puck. Puck is flipped free. It will be icing if it slides on, which it does. So the Steelers don't get the line change they desire.
Fairly fresh unit out there for Sheffield, though, so it shouldn't be too bad. You know, obviously, we're just about 6 minutes gone here in the second period. It doesn't seem like it's taken an awful long time to go through 6 minutes with the play and how quick these guys can transition and put pressure on each other.
Offensive zone face-off following the icing call for the Panthers to work with. Trying to move it clear down the boards. Valdix will take another swing at it. But we've got ourselves a stoppage and an injured Panther in the corner. And that's Boussiers who's down. I have to say, I didn't see
what
happened.
Yeah, the cut on the play there. Is it the puck come through here or stick right up a little bit? We'll see here. The puck comes through and the puck gets them there. Right there, I think it is. As it comes through, it looks like it just comes up underneath the visor. Maybe goes up underneath them, but... Yeah, he's gone straight off the far end there. You can see that it's done a little bit of damage across his nose, it looks like.
It's a nasty one for Boussiers. I'm sure the Panthers want to get him patched up and back out there as soon as possible. The ring staff need to come out. As you can see, all the blood that's down there. That's going to need clearing away. Hopefully it won't take them too long to scrape it free. 5:30 start in Manchester is underway, and the Storm have an early lead. They're 1-0 in front of the Dundee Stars. Remember, the four other games across the Elite League today are all 6 o'clock starts. Steelers' record this season when they've been leading after two periods in league play is Wolves 1-12 and lost 1. That one defeat was here against the Belfast Giants, a game that had so much third period drama and so many suspensions. The only one they've lost in the league from a winning position after 40 minutes, but that one from Pellini inside the first minute of the period really could have changed things.
You look at that one for Perlini and then the other one off the crossbar, but here's the deflection and there's the off the post. So, you know, two of them cancel each other out there, but, you know, Nottingham are still one short off the incredible Mustakov saves earlier on.
Rick technicians look like they are just about finished off. I think the majority of the blood has been cleared away. We're going to be too far away from the restart of this game. It'll be a neutral ice restart. Again, we apologise for not being able to access Twitter. Unfortunately, there's so many people in the building that are struggling to get the signal through to our phones up here next to the White House. So if you have been sending in any messages, we're not ignoring you. We just haven't received them yet. We're expecting a lot of notifications when we get back into the car tonight. Still a couple of other spots. They've cleared away the main drops of blood that were over in that far corner. I think another couple have dripped off on his way off the ice. Boussier, so I think it's those that are just being scraped up at the moment. Looks okay from here, although obviously we are 300 feet away.
I was going to say, you've got really good eyes even through the camera there. We'll see which team comes out of this stoppage with a bit more enthusiasm. It's one of those things you're told during the intermissions, you try and take it in 5-minute blocks or 10-minute blocks, depending on how many goals you need. You know, obviously, Nottingham are looking at 5-minute blocks here. What did we do in the first five? What did we do in the second five? And we need to then step up the pace a little bit more, and we'll see how they react.
Panthers move straight back in. Shot in on Mustakovs by Brown. He's taking the place of Boussier's on this line. They'll get it back for another go. Dropped off, now moved across. Gagnon can move in. This is dangerous. And saved by Mustakovs. He's taken a weird kick off the glass, and Mustakovs didn't know where it was. He was stood up tall as the shot was coming in. Mustakovs throws his arms out and said, "I didn't know where it was." But there was a moment when he was stood up and didn't realise the shot was heading right towards him. Danger averted for the moment for the Steelers. They're into the offensive zone. Armstrong sent towards goal. Knocked off. This Yates was Markov. Moved back up. Panthers are back onto it. Good hands from Phillips. We've seen that a couple of times today. Here's Lindhagen moving through. He left the puck behind. Tried to snap one on goal and he just found fresh air. Good hit in the corner though, but the Steelers have numbers. Armstrong, oh, he just hesitated a moment, and Lee sensed an opportunity. And now Westerling. Oh, that's a dangerous pass out. Turnover and Delago's shot is blocked away. The Steelers nearly played themselves into trouble in their own zone.
Just got to be a little bit careful. Obviously, it's one of those things where you know, the teams are getting stretched out here a little bit. Nottingham's going to take an awful lot more chances, I would have thought. They'll try to open it up a little bit, get their defense more and more into it. And Westerling does a good job there in the corner. He twists and turns. And just unfortunate, he tries to make a little pass coming out of his own zone, and it doesn't quite work out. And as I said before, these teams are so quick to turn it around and get it right back down at you. Any little giveaway or any little takeaway, you know, you're looking at that puck coming right straight back at you.
Commentary will continue as I have not won the 50-50 this week. So not quite the Merry Christmas it could have been, but there are plenty of Steelers fans here who will... I'm not sure actually what they would choose the 2 points over the 50-50 given how large it is. The Steelers enter the offensive zone. Coming across to break up the play was Schaller. Lee. Slides past him and Garnett will have to cover. I think the Steelers will be grateful to spend a little bit of time in the offensive zone as well. Gets a little nudge from Sobek.
This is what I mean. There's things that aren't necessarily needed to do. And Farmer's coming over to have a little whimper there that Waugh was maybe taken down a little easy. But again, why is Sobek coming in to do that? The play is dead. He stood off to the side of the net. So this is the things that you don't want to do. You try not to create too much attention down here. The play's already in your own end. You got to focus on getting the puck back out and down 200 feet to get a goal.
Dowd tried to spin one towards the net. It bounced away off the legs of Brisebois. He's wedged in the corner. Both sides trying to free, and it'll be the Panthers who do. It's good work from Lakovic. Under a lot of pressure. And then the puck will come back in front of the Panthers' goal. Play it out, long pass through from Delago. Oh, and it was taken in, reaching stick from Lakovic. And although he got a block on it, he couldn't quite bring it under perfect control. Then tries to bring it out front, and the Steelers are in the way. There's the shot, and there's the save from Mustakovs. Panthers want a check from behind there. They're not going to get one. It might be a cross-checking call. They want anything right now. They need a route back into this game. They've got less than 12 minutes. And somehow they need to find three. Brisebois. Nelson across, making life difficult. Fitzgerald, in fact, it is, who's over there making the hits. And another stumble. This time the penalty will be called, but the play will still continue. Billingsley's shot and Mustakovs block a save. Now Brown across to the far side. Garnett's on the bench for the extra skater. The Steelers get a touch on that, and that brings about the whistle. And you hate to say this is the Panthers' last chance, but Time is running low.
It is very much so. There's a lot of time left, obviously. We've seen these two teams score a lot of goals quickly, and this is just some good hard work as we see the quick turnaround, but the play goes back in behind the net, and it just gets a stick up underneath the feet, and the player, and the Nottingham player goes down on Arsene, but a lot of that started way, way back when Arsene sort of pinched a little bit in this end, and they tried to string Lakovic on a long, long stretch pass. It just about got in behind, not the defenseman, but it was Levi Nelson who was backtracking on it. So, you know, again, it's good to have your defenseman active in the play, but at this point in the game, your defenseman are defensemen. And that's what we've always been told, is you're up by three, you're in here, you've got the game on the game one. They have to come back and beat you now. You've got enough goals, so now you make sure you play your positions and you keep the puck 200 feet from your net.
2 minutes for tripping on Arsene, 48-39, the time of the penalty. Panthers go on to power play number four, 0-3 so far. Steelers get this one cleared, hammered off the glass. 50-50 prize has been confirmed inside the arena. It's £10,023. Yet again, the Steelers have broken the 10K barrier for a 50-50 prize on Boxing Day. O'Connor, room down centre ice, that's the route he takes. Steelers don't want to chase it, they want to get a change instead. The first minute of penalty has been killed without alarm.
Yeah, Nottingham not being too smart on their dump-ins. That's twice they've dumped it into nobody actually attacking the play.
Oh, and Phillips was asleep here, and Delay goes in behind him. Pass across, and Mustakovs has made a fantastic stack pad stop.
Old school Mustakovs there, a double pad. Dominic Hasek coming across, two pad slide.
Closest the Panthers have been in a while. But the Steelers were just sleeping at their own blue line, and the Panthers are offside here. They can't play it. Although the Steelers got themselves into a bit of bother knowing whether they should leave it or play it. And while they were waiting, the Panthers came out of the zone and went back in. The Steelers do get it clear.
Great work there by Yampton. Strength on the puck there, and again, some persistence to keep at it and put that puck 200 feet down again.
Sauvé forward. The Lego trails, and the puck is knocked past him and judged down the ice, and it's going to be a penalty. Westling was taken down, and as the puck goes back to Garnett, the whistle will go, and it's a tripping call, and it's gone against Mark DeLego.
Yeah, I can't, you know, that's an unfortunate one there. I couldn't see who from Nottingham actually took the puck over the blue line. As we see the replay coming through here, free and clear, and this a nice little fake, but Mustakovs is looking, and he's already across, and that's a great double pad slide. That's something you don't see hardly ever anymore.
If he goes splits there, that can go five hole.
If he goes,
because he slid his right pad underneath, he stopped it.
Yeah. If he goes splits there, or if he goes into butterfly, that's in the back of the net, in my opinion, right there and then. But that double pad saves him a little bit. But going back to that penalty there, if the Nottingham player takes that puck deeper into the zone instead of turning it over 2 feet in front of in the blue line, that penalty doesn't happen.
Brief period of 4-on-4 is over. The Steelers now on a 5-on-4 power play, and they're 2-for-5 tonight. One more goal clinches the game for good. The Steelers may already have enough to win this game. You can never lead by too many against the Panthers. Francilla all the way across to Westerling. Back across, Francilla snaps it. Good block in front by Lee. Westerling, Fretter. Nicely worked into the slot and put into the top corner by the King.
Yeah, another nice play. Well worked. Absolutely fantastic work around the boards. You know, you got some great opportunities there. It went through the seams a couple of times, and then here's your down low, up high. And I don't know if it does go off the defenseman stick yet again, Lee, and then it goes up over the shoulder. But again, you can just see, this is what we were saying with Matthew Wye. You took him out from in front of the net and pulled him back into the high slot, and Westerling is down there. He's the one that's the key lately on the power play. Tomo's moved him down onto that sideboards where he can be a little bit more creative and find the space, but he makes a pass across to Francilla. They work it out really, really well. It goes up, down, and back into the middle of the ice, and it goes in the back of the net.
We've seen a lot of Steelers power play goals this season, but that's one of the slickest passing moves we've seen. Steelers enter the offensive zone. They're looking for another, and it was just wide from Dowd. Goal 12 on the year for Matthew Watt. Shallow goes forward. He's been hooked back. That's going to be a penalty coming the Panthers' way.
Yeah, hooking penalty as Shallow tries to split the defense. And Just gets the stick in there, Valdix, on the back check, and just unfortunate, doesn't quite work out. And again, you know, there's still 8 minutes left. You know, it's a terrible thing to say is I've seen a lot more goals than four scored in 8 minutes. So, again, Sheffield, they've got to be careful. Do all the little things right. Keep the puck moving forward. Don't put yourself in a situation where things like that can happen, and you can take some poor back-checking penalties, let's say. You've got players back in plenty of time and space. You know, don't let yourself get carried away in the moment. Continue doing what you're doing.
So the Panthers get themselves another power play opportunity. Still have a zero on their side of the scoreboard. We've got 8 minutes to do something about it. Steelers, who won 2-0 on Saturday, we're in a similar position here again tonight. That one is deflected out of the zone, and the Steelers get a breather and a line change. Power play 5 for the Panthers. Didn't get to use the full one last time because of the tripping penalty that Delago took. The Steelers scored on that, their third power play goal of the game. Special teams have been a real Steelers strength this season, but all the power play has struggled in recent weeks. It's come back to life tonight. And in some style, another clearance all the way down to Garnett, and the Steelers crowd is loving every minute of this right now. Some of the Panthers fans decided that 4 was enough and headed to the exits on that Wah goal. Wallace. Steelers into the zone, 4-on-4, look at the handling, look at this, oh, it's off target from Wallace, but the combinations between Tim Wallace and Ben O'Connor, well, the team was short-handed, quite something, and then Yamtin stops the Panthers taking their preferred route down the ice. Clark tips it in, Mustakovs decides to go back and let Matheson deal with it. Farmer down the boards. Here's Schaller. Works it down low. Feeding it across the crease. The puck is sitting there. The Steelers need to clear it, and they do. It broke nicely, and the Steelers got it all the way down the ice, and that will kill the penalty. Andreas Valdix. And step back out onto the ice. And here comes Brisebois. Shot from Farmer into the corner. Schaller. He spins and sends it to Mustakovs, and he will cover it between the pads.
Yeah, I give Mustakovs a lot of credit there. He stood tall in the near post and a couple of whacks at the short side, but good job. You see the power play goal. There's a nice passing backward, forward, back and forward, side to side, and up and down. It's in the back of the net. I think Matthew Waugh is probably the happiest guy on the ice right there as well. Good to see him getting back on the score sheet. You know, we talked about him before the game, didn't we, that we needed to see him get there, and who passes him the puck?
This was given to Westerling.
Westerling was on the boards. He was down low.
Fretter.
That's the other guy we want to see.
Fans letting you know that more of the away supporters are leaving the building. I'm sure we'll hear a few more renditions of that as the seconds wind down. Garnett has got this one covered. Panthers will get their chance at revenge tomorrow. These two teams go at it again, 7 o'clock down at the NIC, another sold-out night. Opportunity here from the face-off, oh, and it wouldn't quite settle down for Armstrong. Still an opportunity. Fitzgerald's shot takes a deflection to the corner. So perfectly for Fitzgerald to wind and really drive one. The hit body's en route. Brown traps that against the wall. He's worked hard. We've had a lot of reward tonight. There's a tumble. No penalty. Lockhart pops straight back up, and the Steelers will try and transition through. And they will get into the offensive zone. Shooting chance from the angle, and the save made by Garnett off the blocker. That was good from Wallace. He's had one of his more impressive games of the season tonight, Tim Wallace. Picked up an assist on that third goal when he came out of the penalty box, but there are signs that this unit, as you were just alluding to, is starting to come to life. Wallace again. There's Waugh. Back with Freta. Wallace. Billingsley gives him a nudge. Gets him off the puck and allows Lindhagen to try and skate away. Turns away from Waugh, then turns up ice. And he skated into trouble. Turnover, save made by Garnett. Follow-up chance. And the save is made again. And Billingsley was back to help out his netminder.
Yeah, Lindhagen gets away with it there. You see, just loses control. Just runs away from him. And Colton Ferner comes in and does a good job blocking it through. And turns around to Wallace. Bit unfortunate for Wallace. He thinks he doesn't have as much time as he does. And Garnett has to come up big. And there's a rebound as well. And there's the cross check in the back. You see that clears Freder out of the way, and Garda just stretches out to grab that puck.
So no penalties called on the play. 4:30 remaining in this game. Steelers win the puck from the draw and again get it down low behind the end line. And it'll be Spang who emerges with it. That's Valdix to Pellini. Cross for Schaller. Takes the shot on, blocker saved by Mustakovs. The Steelers defenseman to it first, as they have been for almost the entire night. Fife have taken the lead against Edinburgh. First goal of the 6 o'clock starts. It's gone to the Flyers. Brisebois to Pellini. That big opportunity at the start of the third period. Go back in time and wonder how that might have changed the game. Big hit in the corner, but Panthers retain possession. Here's Slee. Schaller looking for room. The shot is wide. The follow-up attempt is blocked. Steelers will get this one airborne to clear the zone. Sauvé back. Fired straight forward and tipped on by Clark. Mustakovs comes out. Has to be careful.
Yeah.
Oh, and he's fanned on it, and now he's got to get back. This isn't a mess. And Mustakovs just about got back, and then Kirk down the boards, but not fully out. The Panthers are swarming. It was all the Steelers' own doing. Sauvé cutting back onto the forehand, checked off the puck, and now the Steelers can break. It's a two-on-one. There's only Lee back. The Steelers are into the zone. Drop pass, Westerling. Oh, the pass from Kirk was just a bit too heavy for him. Kirk will get it back for another go, and he can't take it past Sauvé and Lakovic. But a 2-on-1 became a 3-on-1, and the passing wasn't as slick as it needed to be. Billingsley hammers one, Mustakovs gloves it, and the crowd love that one.
Yeah, that's probably the safest place for that puck right now, for Mustakovs is in his glove. You're always tempting fate when you see him going out of the net and trying to do a little bit too much. He's not bad when he moves it quickly, but when he second-guesses and goes somewhere else, and I think it's a little, does that take a little deflection there, maybe by Lindhagen in front? Mustakovs comes through, but they're quick to break, aren't they, Sheffield? It wasn't just a one-on-one or a two-on-one. It ended up being a four-on-one with the defenseman coming up into play as well. So excellent opportunity there after a turnover by Mustakovs to get another goal. But again, Sheffield, you can't allow Nottingham to get any life going into tomorrow either. You don't want them to get one here late on. To give them a little bit of energy and a little bit of belief in their system that they can do something at home. You want to keep it down to where it is now.
Fitzgerald strong on the puck. Doesn't get past Billingsley. Might do this time. Well, he gets across the blue line at least. That's good enough for the Steelers. Betteridge around the boards. Mustakovs doesn't get a stop on this one. There's Farmer. Sends it across. Oh, it was just out of the reach of Betteridge. Billingsley back behind the goal. The Panthers are looking for something here. And it's caught up in amongst all those sticks and skates. Where on earth is this going to drop? What a scramble that is. And the Steelers emerge with possession and clear it down the ice. It'll cost them icing, but I don't think they'll mind. That was chaos. Just to be on the blue paint.
Yeah, this is what we said. We don't want to give them too much life here going into their own game. They've got to recontrol the game here a little bit, Sheffield. Bring it back down to this end and just try and keep it down here and give Mustakovs the opportunity to get a little bit of wind back in his lungs and relax and refocus for the last part of this game.
Shot from Brisebois. Puck is there. Oh, it was nearly opportunity for Mokshantsev. Net was open for a minute, but just wouldn't quite fall right, and that's been the story of the Panthers' day, really. And the clear chances have come, they haven't taken them. Mustakos has made a couple of great saves. They've missed an open net or two. Mustakos gets across and blocks that one. And the follow-up shot is intercepted, and the Steelers get in the way of that pass and send it into neutral ice. Panthers still seeking this consolation. Here's Fretta. Final minute of play. Steelers might not be done yet. Markov trying to bring it back onto the forehand and flick it, but didn't make good contact. And here's Spang. The crowd is clapping the team home to victory. The work's not done just yet. Everyone rises to their feet. It's going to be a standing ovation for the Steelers in this one. Wallace backhands it into the zone. Here's Gagnon. Farmer trying to skate away from Warren. Pass Fretta. And straight to O'Connor. He goes off the board, but it doesn't get out. Gallego got a block on it, and the Steelers will intercept. And they just want to kill these final few seconds, and Wallace will calmly do so. And what a performance from the Sheffield Steelers. A 4-0 victory on Boxing Day against the Nottingham Panthers. Their losing streak drops to 7 in a row in all competitions, but the Steelers can celebrate. And it's back-to-back shutouts for Irvin's Mustakos. What a night here at the Fly DSA Arena.
Yeah, we'll just have a look at some of the replays here, and there's the first one to Levi Nelson, which turns out to be the game-winning goal. So excellent work there by Matheson to hold the puck up and do the job that he needs to. You know, he's keep pulling players to him and creating some time and space, and then you get the slippery little Levi Nelson getting in behind the defenseman there. Everybody does their job there. Robbie Dowd pulls the defender out, and Levi Nelson deposits it in the open net.
Handshake line is currently taking place. Stay with us on Steelers TV Live. We'll have the Man of the Match awards for both sides, and of course the Eddie, the fast lap from the Sheffield Steelers Man of the Match. Four different scorers, plus the shutout from the netminder. Plenty of options for the people who decide these things.
You said a good thing there, four different scores. And that's exactly what a team needs when you are struggling a little bit to score goals. You need someone to step up and get one, but to get four different players on the score sheet, yeah, there's some power play goals set in there, but it's good to see that it's different players on the power play scoring goals as well. It's not the same person that's burying two or three and getting multi-goal games. So excellent work on the power play. You saw Sheffield move the puck around very, very well and very, very confident, which is what they needed to do. But then again, you look at the opportunities that Nottingham had. Nottingham did have the opportunity to score some goals. A bit unfortunate on a couple of the opportunities that they didn't put it in the back of the net. So for as much as it's a negative and a 4-0 loss for Nottingham, there were some positives to come out of the game. And I'm sure Corey Nelson will try to build his team up, just like Paul Thompson's had to do over the last few weeks as well, is try and build more on the positive than all the negative that's coming at them from every different direction.
Fife have taken a 3-goal lead at home to Edinburgh. Cardiff are 1-0 up at home against Coventry. So it'll be the visitors' man of the match to be presented first. And Michael Garnett is the man of the match for the visitors tonight.
Not much you could do on a couple of the goals, to be fair, deflection goals, and to be fair, even the last Matthew Waugh goal was a deflection that seemed to just travel up Lee's stick. So, you know, all in all, he had some very, very good saves and kept the team where it should have been.
So the Panthers will make their way around to acknowledge the support from both sides, and a few remaining supporters, most have taken the opportunity to get out of the car park and down the M1. And the Steelers have got to make that trip tomorrow. The Panthers and Steelers will go back at it again in the NIC tomorrow. £10,023, the winning prize on the 50-50, not quite as high as last year, but still an incredible amount of money. And well done to those lucky ladies. Nelson is going to come across and present the money. But if they're going to get all that in cash, they do as an answer, they could have a bank transfer instead. Be a nervous walk to the car otherwise with that in your back pocket.
Might be pretty heavy too, the Dolan pound points.
Will be. Brayhead lead Belfast by a goal to nil, and Cardiff are now two up on Coventry. So we don't have a final shot count yet from the Sheffield Steelers. The Panthers had 12 in that final period for a total of 30. The Panthers also had 12 penalty minutes. They went 0 for 5 on the power play. The Steelers went 3 for 6.
Big opportunity there. That tells the story, doesn't it? You go 500 on the power play. That's a great job by Sheffield to show some dominance on that, as well as the penalty killing. They came up big. A lot of block shots. Very, very difficult for Nottingham to get anything through to Mustakovs as well. You saw a lot of shots being deflected or tipped or forced to go wide, with players coming out of the lane to get decent opportunities.
Matt Marquardt chosen as the shirt off the back winner. So all that remains now is the announcement of the Steelers' man of the match and the fast lap. We'll see who gets the nod tonight. The crowd are calling Moose. See what the decision is. It is Mark Matheson who gets the Man of the Match award for the Sheffield Steelers tonight, and a huge smile across his face. And why wouldn't it be? A goal and an assist. And he'll get to do the Eddie.
Not to mention about three or four or five block shots as well. So good job by him all the way around, offensively and defensively, taking control.
So here goes Mark Matheson. Taking his time, he wants to soak it all in. Most of the Steelers fans have stayed behind to watch. He's applauding them, the crowd are applauding him. And he's loving it at the Sheffield Steelers, and the Steelers are loving having him on their blue line. In fact, everywhere on the ice with performances like the one he's put in today.
Well, that's what you get with Mark Matheson. You know, he's come over as a defenseman that can move the puck and be offensive, and you can see how well he can control the play. He controls the play, definitely jumping up, and that's why Tomo threw him up as a centerman there to see just how good he was as he's played a little bit in the past. But, you know, again, through all three zones, he's very, very capable. He doesn't get flustered hardly at all, to be fair, no matter what the pressure is on him. And he's just very, very consistent, and he works very, very hard, and he deserves a lot of the credit that he gets.
Shot count for the Steelers in that final period was 7, so they ended up with 32 shots to the Panthers 30. A shutout victory for the Steelers against the Panthers. It's shutout 18 of Irvin Mustakov's Steelers careers. He shared one of those with Jeff Woolhouse. 17 all to himself, but 18 in total, and back-to-back home shutouts. And the Steelers with a win that will please everybody in Orange. It's going to be a good fun with people trying to find a negative out of this one. It's been good from start to finish for the Steelers. They scored early, they scored often, and the Panthers didn't score at all. And as the Steelers make their way off the ice, it's time for us to sign off as well. On behalf of everyone who has watched the webcast tonight, we thank you for joining us. Remember, the Steelers are next in action here on Saturday. That is December the 30th, with Manchester Storm, the visitors. We'll have the goals on Facebook later tonight, the highlights on YouTube tomorrow, and the full game download available in the next day or two. Log back into the Steelers TV Live website, and it'll be there in your archive to download and keep forever. But on behalf of the entire Steelers TV crew, Ron Shudra, this is Jonathan Fernley signing off. Final score from the Fly DSA Arena: Sheffield Steelers 4, Nottingham Panthers 0.